In our Commitment 2008 coverage this morning, Senator Hillary Clinton is the comeback kid once again.
We're going on, we're going strong, and we're going all the way.
She grabbed big wins in critical contests yesterday, scoring primary victories in Texas, Ohio, and Rhode Island.
Barack Obama won in Vermont. The trio of victories puts a dent in Obama's delegate lead, but it's at this point not enough for Clinton to take over, or to overtake, rather, the Illinois senator.
The primaries did put John McCain over the top. This morning, he does have enough delegates to claim the Republican Party's nomination, with a sweep of all the states in play. Today, McCain will have lunch at the White House. He's expected to pick up President Bush's official endorsement. Former Arkansas Governor Mike Huckabee has dropped out of the race shortly after McClain clinched the GOP nod. Joining us now to break it all down, KCRA 3 political analyst Steve Swatt. Steve, nice to have you back in here. I know you watched late into the evening. Anything stick out and surprise you, especially maybe with a margin of victory for Senator Clinton?
Well, the only thing that surprised me a little bit was the margin of victory for Senator Clinton in Ohio. Mm-hmm. I mean, she was ahead according to the polls, and we know how dangerous that is to read the polls, but she was ahead by 4 to 6 points. They were hoping for a 3 to 5 to 6 point victory, and it turned out to be larger than that. I was a little surprised that Senator Obama wasn't a little bit closer in Texas. He had a lead going into the weekend, but the weekend polling showed that his momentum was stalling, and so that clearly was an indication that he might have some difficulty.
At this point, though, they're still counting the caucus vote?
That is. That's true. The caucus has actually started after the polls closed last night in Texas. Texas, don't even get into Texas. It is strange the way they select their delegates, but two-thirds of the delegates are selected based on the popular vote in the primary, and one-third based on the caucuses, and the caucuses are still being counted. We should know that today.
Okay, so...
And Obama's winning the caucuses,
so what would
by the way.
That mean? If he wins the caucuses, that means what to all of this?
Then he will get some more delegates, and he will pad his lead.
Now, you mentioned that Obama had stalled over the weekend. What was the reason, in your mind, for the stall, or was Mrs. Clinton getting her message out to the unions?
Well, I think she was getting a message out, and we're not exactly sure which message that was, because in the last several days she was throwing everything against the wall to see what would stick. Mm-hmm. And what appears to have stuck, at least in Ohio, was her, interestingly enough, her apparent opposition to NAFTA, even though her husband, the former president, was the one who engineered NAFTA, the
right.
trade agreement,
right.
which has hurt a lot of the Ohio residents. And so she came out pretty strong on that and said she would be the strongest individual to move the economy forward. Also, the national security issue, that red phone ad, a lot of people are saying that may have had an impact.
There were national Republican talk show hosts and other Republicans who were encouraging some Republicans in those states to vote for Hillary Clinton to try to drag out the Democratic thing. Do you think people actually did?
I don't think so much, and that was in Texas, where mm-hmm. Republicans could vote for a Democrat or vice versa, mm-hmm. and independents could vote for anybody. If you look at the exit polls, Republicans and independents who voted in the Democratic primary voted for Obama.
Interesting.
All right, Steve Swatt with the very latest. Steve, thank you for coming in early this morning.